God bless America.
Oh.
4, 5, 6, 7! 7! 7!
So I'm gonna be cheating.
It's a dream.
You should get that.
Holy shit.
Let's go! Welcome back to Nickel City X-Wing. My name's Greg, and we have got two more big matchups for you tonight. Let me get game one off the thing. This match between Drew and Catherine first, representing the Korg Federacy of Independent Systems.
Roger, roger. Roger, roger.
It's Team Captain Drew, and representing Team Fox. It's Team Captain Catherine. Team Fox currently finds themselves in a 2-1 hole. Catherine looking to tie it. Drew looking to give the CFIS their first victory on the year. You can see from the three objectives that this is a scramble the transmission. Betting is open. I've seen the last pieces get placed. Classic scum versus Republic here. Ten bands on Catherine all day. A lot of these SOC cards are not spawning the correct amount of shields. So Click should have an extra shield, yes. Jag has 3. Wolf was 3. Oddball should have 4. Yep, that's right. The overlays seem to got it. Crispy, captain of Team Avid, thank you so much for the resub. Appreciate you, buddy. We're about ready. Catherine's setting dials. Looks like Drew's got their dials set. About ready to get game 2 underway. Should be a good one. Jane, thank you. looks like we are underway. Jag, one straight. And Jag will lock. Rock. Everyone doing the pre. Boss gonna actually reinforce. Can you lock objectives? I don't believe so. Genesis red, barrel rolling. And Cad Bane going pretty fast. Cat is going to cloak. Click will grab locks. And put two of them out there. Go into Jag and Wolf. And Shakti will boost. All right, we're going to head into round two. Round two is when they can start claiming objectives. Let's check in on the bets. Bets right now, 3 for Drew, 11 for Catherine. 3-11. I know you never bet against Catherine, but whew, you guys really taking that to heart. I'll stop betting on Catherine when Floyd Mayweather loses the fight. But he ain't gonna fight no more. Exactly. Well, Bosca's about to joust 3 ships. Well, he's gonna joust 2 ships with Jag coming in as a third. He's got Cannon there. You gotta think that Click's moving slow enough to capture. Cad's well within the ability to make a difference here. Gen Red probably not going to get to do a torpedo this turn. Maybe if Wolf moves before, Gen Red can move fast, get a lock. What, you think, Sherman, you're getting free bets on Catherine? Bro, she beat me like 20 to 3. Catherine's like single-handedly turned people off of gambling. Here we go with the road roll for turn two. That's going to stay on Drew. Because she's using Siege of Coruscant ships and they're severely undercosted. There's a system phase boost for Shaak Ti. Cad didn't decloak, so. Kanan, one bank focus. Kanan's force gonna get a workout here. Jag. Woo! Look at that flying. Reinforce for Bossk. Cad will bank and claim. Genesis might get a Protorp here. Be obstructed, but it's not so bad. So Genesis will get a lock, and pilot ability will grant Genesis Red a focus. Can you claim cloaked? Yes, you can claim cloaked. Salvage is the only one where you can't. Wolf, moving fast. There's a focus for Wolf. Too hard. Click will claim. Oh, that's right. I forgot to make the joust zone. Forgot about that. Shaak Ti just went fast. Oddball, gonna go fast. Oddball. Range 2 into Bosk getting cannons. So that's 2 dice. Yes, Drew is the one who set up that objective in Catherine's territory. I think that was just to keep one ship back from the initial engagement. Does Oddball spend here? Probably. Oddball debating on the spend here. Oddball does spend. And that is a shield and a notorious charge. That'll give Jag a lock. Boss gonna go into Oddball and Greedo. And that'll be 4 shields on Oddball. Cad Bane, no shots. Gen Red. Protorp into Jag from Genesis Red. Probably should go ahead and close this betting, huh? And that'll be 2 shield, or 2 hits, 2 crits into Jag. Jag rolls 2 defense dice. One evade, one eye. Jack could spend, take 1, or lose shields. Jag will spend, take 2. Click, no shots. Shakti, no shots. Wolf. So cannon here, so that is going to be 2 dice into Bosk. Boss takes another shield. And then Jag. Range 3 here. No more Kanan Force left, so. Hit, hit, crit, beauty. And that is going to be another shield. And get a synchronized console. It's going to pass the lock. Give it to Wolf. And they will each gain a point. Yeah, the veteran tail gunners are going to do pretty good work here. The problem is being able to follow up on, I mean, like, a great first round on Oddball, right? Got Oddball shields down. Now, can you follow up on Oddball? And I think Oddball's in the perfect spot to maybe not be able to. I think Jack might too hard right. Yeah, possibly. So I think Genesis really wants to bank right here and lock onto Oddball. But I also think this is going to be a turn where Cad Bane is decloaking. Should be able to line up a heavy laser cannon on somebody. Can Genesis go forward? Yes. I think you probably can go two forward and be okay. Catherine takes over, turn 3. I four boosts. And a decloak from Cad Bane. Jag moving quick. Jag will focus. And in one straight. Thought about the jam, but decided not to. Shark T, three banking. We're gonna roll left for Shuck T, line up that bullseye. Wolf the one hard. Nice little focus for Wolf. Click, three forward. And Click's gonna compare the lock, or go for a lock. I really think that you put this on oddball. All right, well, I'm just gonna lock Jag. I mean, it's not bad, right? Like, locking Jag isn't a bad play. And this should be a boost focus. Contraband, stop, reinforce to the front. Oddball. One forward. Gosh, Oddball could be dead this turn if Genesis had locked Oddball. Got that Protorp off. There's the Phobos from Oddball. Never mind. Just kidding. Oddball. Range one, do we get the cannon here? All right, gonna cannon this down to three. Oddball rolls. Hit crit. And that's going to be a panicked pilot on boss who now is sitting on three stress. And I believe Catherine's fours are going to be the first to shoot. Click, range three into Bosk. Not a great roll. Not going to bother spending anything there. Wolf range one into Bosk. We'll use the lock. We'll spend and Tito. Hikrit and Bosk. It's a damaged engine. Surprised he's not sending out his second Notorious. All right, 3v3 into Kanan. For one. Marksmanship for a crit. Kanan evades. All right, let's... Bosk into Oddball. Click will use their ability. Bosk will Greedo. And it's going to split, so that's four more in Oddball. So Gen Red could try and kill Oddball. Jack's still pretty healthy. Gen Red into Oddball for a crit. Oddball rolls one. It's a blank. Let's see what it goes in Oddball here. It's a damage sensor array. Tad now. That ion cannon range 3 to put the final no, never mind. Gonna go into HLC into Jag for 3. We go into Jag. So Jag is down to 4. And we'll use the Cad Bane ability to pass the stress token to Jag. Jag does have Bosk. Range 1, double modified. Good start. Jack will spend the lock. Sing for 3. 2 into Bosque. Bosque down to 3. One crit in the oddball. Oddball! Dead. That's a huge kill there. And 1 point each at the end of the round. Round 4 starts. Drew up 7-2 over Catherine, but we know that's tenuous at best. So Bosque is all but dead. Bosque shouldn't get another action. But with the I-5 out, at least Bosque will get to shoot. That's the big thing here. Yeah, what Pim just said. Sorry, I'm watching the Saber game while this is happening. Greg, end of game, can we see the first damage card on Bosque? Should have been a crit with Greedo. Would have been a damage sensor, right? Bottom left. Blinded pilot. So Pelly's gonna fix the damaged engine. Kanan went forward. Hey Greg, when can we expect Nickel City crop tops on the store page? You know, if the demand is there for crop tops, I'll put one out there. Jack will bump. Jag does take the red focus. CAD will focus. There was a claim there as well. Gen Red bumped a friendly, so won't get to do anything. Wolfie, 4K, beautiful. Listen, I'll make the crop top, but, you know, better get ordered. See if Streamlabs even has, see if my merch site has crop tops. Merch store. Create new item. Tank tops? No. Other. Sports bra. One piece swimsuit. I don't see crop tops here. Yeah, the best I can do is the sports bra. It doesn't look like crop top is an option. The closest thing to a crop top is the sports bra. Oh, wait. Never mind. Well, what do I know? Crop top. All right, what do we want on it? Do we just want the logo? What do you want on the crop top? I just heard start of engagement while I'm fucking Dimple City X with two folks. Oh my god. Well, I can't. Greedoing for two crits. Can click evade this. Should be able to.
have it. All right.
Let me take away my profit on this so they're cheaper. Oh my god, if that happened at Gen Con, I would flip my shit. Campa. Here you go. Nickel City X-Wing crop tops. I haven't paid a single piece of attention to what's happened in the game. Looks like Jag is down to 2. Click. Wait, can we click the thing? It should be available to purchase. Oh, Bossk, Vady Boy. No Jag ability there. Shark T. Wolf. Anybody. Wasn't that range 1? Sure was, but Kanan. Range 0 into Kanan, out the front first for Jag. Jag's a knight 3. Kanan evades. VTG into... Greg, are there no other options besides the size they have listed? Yes, I don't get to control the sizes. You would think if it's a crop top, it'd be like small and medium. Like, I don't know. I don't actually know. I don't know what size. I don't wear crop tops. That is a... Disabled power regulator on Bossk. Bossk is sitting at 2, I believe. My God. Shock T, go for it. Range 3. 3v2, no mods. Bosk takes two. I think that's the end of Bosk. Kanan. Range zero into Jag. For nothing. Don't blame me. I was busy putting together a crop top. You don't know the things I go through while you all are doing things. Yeah, they're going to rewatch the game and be like, they just talked about crop tops the entire game. All right, so Wolf is going to attack Kanan. Well, they're available now in the merch store. Wolf ability to reroll. Blanks into blanks. And that's going to be a shield on Kanan. And Maul will trigger. I thought Jag was going to, or Shakti was going to do her ability, but nope. Catherine gets 2 points. Wait, nope. 2-1 for Drew. All right, turn 5. We got 20 minutes left, heading in around 5. It's 10-9, Catherine. So killing Jag seems like the quickest way to a couple more points here. Kanan is good enough where you start to wonder if he should exist. Maybe tonight after the games, I'll put together like a blinded pilot crop top. I'll let you guys know. I didn't realize crop tops are going to be so popular. Had I have known. Wolf bumps friendly. And we'll take a damage. Click will claim. Ooh, Shakti the one hard over the cloud. And still on the cloud. Shakti will roll for the ion. And we'll gain the ion. I think the plan was to get Shakti to CAD one bank that only hits enemies though, so CAD's still there. Wolf and Click get the first shots here. The world is Wolf's oyster here. Wolf still deciding. Gen Red. We'll see if this gets Kanan'd. Does not. Hit crit into Gen Red. Gen Red will spend elusive. And Gen Red takes a crit. Click now. Jen. For one. Jag will get a lock there. Gen Red, range zero to Jag. For one. Jag down to one. Cad range one. Into Jag. Surprised this wasn't clicked. And that's going to be a kill on Jag. That is an initiative kill on Jag. He didn't say ion cannon, so. Kanan, range one into click. For one. Click. Evades. At the end of the round, 2-1 for Catherine. And it's 14-12 for Drew. Turn six with 8 minutes left. This will likely be the last round if they play at this pace. Click is not ioned. The only person that's ioned right now is Shock T. Cad also forgot to dump the stress onto the dying Jag, so Cad is stressed. All right, 6.5 minutes left. Looks like they're eroding. Reroad. Catherine has the initiative. One strike, clicks, jams click. Shock T will pick up the focus. So click first lock Shock T, then locks. All right, hold on. I believe there was a ruling about this where it goes by player order. So you would actually take both your locks first, and then Andrew would choose the one that gets locked off. So she chose Wolf and Kanan, and he chose to Dunrev is turning away. And CAD. CAD dialed in the 5K and he doesn't want to do it. So he's going to go ahead and take the two white. So Wolf. Range one into Kanan. I think he was feared it was going to go off the board. We'll use the Wolfpack ability to spend the lock. And focus for three. Kanan will take two. So, well, Kanan, the range one there, so it was going to be four, but it's back down to three. Just one into Genred, and Genred evades. 1 minute and 48 seconds is left. Kanan, range one into Wolf. Or crit. Wolf takes that shield. End phase, Shock T will purple coordinate. So 14:15, and we're going to get one turn left. So if I'm Catherine, I'm barrel rolling Shock T, and then one Harding and just claiming. Time is up. I don't know how Drew wins this. Honestly. I don't have no control on the border. That's TTS. Turn 7, here we go. One straight, focus. I just don't see a way. Pretty sure Catherine has this. And red, one heart. Tries to claim, can't do it. Tad can't claim. That's gonna be it. Wolf will shoot into Kanan. Yeah, he's still at Contra. And Kanan will die. And Genesis dies to a direct hit.
Greg was right! Greg was right!
It really kind of feels like Andrew just gave up to me. I don't know. Well, that's a 15-25 win for Catherine. You're welcome. There it is. The series is at 2-2. It'll come down to Charles Holcomb versus Jimmo. All right, we're going to go to the starting screen, and we'll be back with Game 3 starting soon.